हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू ऑनलाइन वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ जेट प्रोपल्शन एंड एयरक्राफ्ट इंजीनियरिंग। दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 12 फॉर द चैप्टर 1 कॉल्ड फंडामेंटल ऑफ गैस डायनेमिक्स। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू सी वन मोर न्यूमेरिकल्स। सो लेट्स से इट्स अ न्यूमेरिकल नंबर 6 वेयर वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व वन मोर एग्जाम्पल्स एंड देयरफॉर यू शुड बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड दीज न्यूमेरिकल्स मोर क्लियरली एंड you should be able to solve them in written exam. So let's start the session. Now if you look at the numerical, it says the jet of gas at 593 Kelvin has a Mach number of 1.2, means it has considered the temperature and the Mach number, means there is a jet of gas which has a temperature of 593 Kelvin and a Mach number is 1.2. Here gamma that need to take as 1.3 and R, which is characteristic gas constant, that need to take 469 joule per kilogram Kelvin. So these are the data which are given to us. On the basis of these data we need to calculate the local and stagnation conditions of velocity of sound and enthalpy, as well as the maximum attainable velocity of the jet. So here we need to calculate total 5 different things. The first thing is that local velocity of sound A, then a stagnation velocity of sound AO, furthermore local enthalpy H, and stagnation enthalpy, which is HO. So these are the 4 different things that we need to calculate in first term. In second term we need to calculate the maximum velocity which can be obtained by the jet or by this jet. So here we need to calculate C max, maximum velocity, which is C max. So to solve this numerical we need to go through the 5 different things for the numericals. So these are the given data. It says the temperature T 593 Kelvin, then gamma which is 1.3, characteristic gas constant R which is 469 joule per kilogram Kelvin, and Mach number that is 1.2. So these are the 4 different things which we need to consider to solve the numerical. On the basis of that we need to calculate A, which is local velocity of sound or static velocity of sound, then AO, a stagnation velocity of sound, then H is a static enthalpy, and HO is a stagnation enthalpy, and the one more thing is C max, which is the maximum velocity which can be obtained. So these are the 5 different things that we need to go through to solve the numerical. Okay, so let's start the session. First of all, let's find out the first term, which is local velocity of sound. And we know that the formula to calculate the local velocity of sound, A is equal to under root of gamma R T. Since we have gamma R and T, we can calculate the local velocity of sound by using this formula. Furthermore, if gamma and R is not given, we need to assume that. So you can assume gamma as a 1.4 and R as a 287 if it is not given. But here both gamma and R is given, so we are going to put the values in the equation. So let's say A is equal to under root of gamma RT, and therefore A is equal to under root of 1.3 into 469 into 593, which is the temperature of jet. Going through the calculation, we'll get A is equal to 609.29 meter per second. So this is our first finding, local velocity of sound or static velocity of sound. Therefore we need to calculate on the basis of that the further terms, and that is the stagnation velocity of sound. But to calculate the stagnation velocity of sound we need a stagnation temperature, since only the static temperature is given, and on the basis of that we have already calculated the static velocity of sound. But for to calculate the stagnation velocity of sound we need a stagnation temperature, which is TO. So first of all, let's calculate the stagnation temperature. Now here we are going to use the Mach number relations, and that was taught in a theory session of the chapter number 1. So here stagnation temperature, we are going to use the Mach number relations, in which the stagnation, the ratio of stagnation to static temperature TO to T is equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 upon 2 m square, Mach number square. Since we have gamma, we have Mach number m, and we have capital T, which is a static temperature, here we are going to calculate the stagnation temperature. So let's put the values here. So let's say TO upon 593, which is temperature, that is equal to 1 plus 1.3 minus 1, which is gamma, divided by 2 into 1.2 square, which is the Mach number. Going through the calculation, we will get TO upon 593, which is equal to 1.216. We just calculate the left hand side. And therefore, TO is equal to 721.08 Kelvin. So this is stagnation temperature. Now, on the basis of stagnation temperature, we can calculate the stagnation velocity of sound. We are going to use the same formula, but instead of A, we need AO, which is the stagnation velocity of sound. So therefore, instead of T, we are going to use the temperature called the stagnation temperature, TO. And the formula says AO is equal to under root of gamma R TO. We have gamma R and TO we just calculated in previous slide. So let's put the values here. Let's say AO is equal to under root of 1.3 into 469 into 721.08. Going through the calculation, we'll get AO is equal to 663.05 meter per second. So this is our second finding, which is the stagnation velocity of sound. Now let's move forward to calculate the static and stagnation enthalpy. So the next term here, that we need to calculate the static enthalpy, and the formula is very simple. That is the basic formula of thermodynamics that we have used many times in different subjects. We know that enthalpy is equal to specific heat into T, H is equal to Cp into T. So that we are going to use to calculate the static enthalpy. But the specific heat is not given. Though we have a T, specific heat is not given. So to calculate the specific heat, we are going to use the relation Cp is equal to gamma R upon gamma minus 1. Gamma R upon gamma minus 1. So what we are going to use? The equations of, or the relations of specific heat would be implied in these equations, and therefore that can be written as H is equal to gamma into R upon gamma minus 1 into T. We have gamma R and T, so we can calculate the H. Let's say gamma is equal to 1.3, characteristic gas constant R is equal to 469 and temperature is 593. So let's put the values here. So therefore H is equal to 1.3 into 469 divided by 1.3 minus 1 into 593, and therefore H is equal to 1205 into 10 raised to 3 joule per kilogram. The term, the unit would be joule per kilogram. You can either convert it in kilojoule per kilogram as well if you want. So this is our third finding, static enthalpy. Similarly, we need to calculate the stagnation enthalpy, which is HO. Same equation, but instead of H, we need HO. So therefore, we are going to use TO instead of T, which is stagnation temperature, and that we just calculated to calculate the stagnation velocity of sound. So let's use the equation HO is equal to Cp into TO. Since Cp is not given here, so we are going to use the relations called gamma R upon gamma minus 1. So let's put these relations in the equations, and the equation would become HO is equal to gamma R upon gamma minus 1 into TO. Let's put the values of gamma, R and TO, and therefore these equations can be rewrite as HO is equal to 1.3 into 469 divided by 1.3 minus 1 into 721.08. After going through the calculation, we'll get HO is equal to 1465 into 10 raised to 3 joule per kilogram. So this is our fourth finding, which is a stagnation enthalpy HO. Now let's move forward to the next finding. Here we need to, in fifth finding or the last finding, we need to calculate the maximum velocity that can be attained by this jet, by the jet that we have considered. So we need to calculate the Cmax. Now to get the Cmax, we are going to use the stagnation enthalpy equation. And the stagnation enthalpy equation, it says that HO is equal to A square divided by gamma minus 1 plus 1 divided by 2 C square. HO is equal to A square divided by gamma minus 1 plus 1 divided by 2 C square, which can also be rewrite as, that is equal to 1 divided by 2 C max square, or which is also equal to AO square divided by gamma minus 1. So these are the three different terms to calculate the HO. Now from this equation, which is HO is equal to A square upon gamma minus 1 plus 1 divided by 2 C square is equal to 1 divided by 2 C square, which is also equal to AO square divided by gamma minus 1. So here we are going to use these relations, and we are going to write a couple of a small part of these relations, which is 1 divided by 2 C max square, which is equal to AO square divided by gamma minus 1. Here we need to calculate the C max. Since we have AO and gamma, so this term can be utilized to calculate the Cmax. We cannot use the other term, because in that term we need the value of C, which is not available at all. So therefore we are just neglecting that term, and we are going to use the relations of HO, and that can be rewrite as 1 divided by 2 Cmax square, which is equal to AO square divided by gamma minus. And therefore C max square is equal to, we are going to take 1 divided by 2 into the other side. So C max square is equal to 2 AO square divided by gamma minus 1. Now to calculate the C max, we are going to take the other side in under root. So C max is equal to under root of 2 AO square divided by gamma minus 1. Since we have gamma, we have stagnation velocity of sound, so we are going to put this value in this equation. So let's put the values here, and therefore the Cmax can be the equations can be rewrite as Cmax is equal to under root of 2 into 663.05 square divided by 1.3 minus 1. Right, you just put the values here, and that afterward the Cmax can be rewrite as under root of 2 into 663.05 square divided by 1.3 minus 1. Going through the calculations, you will get Cmax, where Cmax is equal to 1711.9 meter per second. So this is our last finding. It says that this jet has an ability to travel maximum at this speed. This jet can attain the maximum speed, which is 1711.9 meter per second, which is Cmax. So this is our last finding of these numericals. Now if you have any doubt regarding the numericals, regarding the equations that we have used, you can write down in the comment box. Thank you very much.